Hard to pick out a gift you know someone will use and love, so we're here to kind of help that. We've been sharing our favorite things with you, and some of this stuff might help you cross a few things off your holiday shopping list, and today is my turn!
Yay, I can't wait!
Okay, so I've always gotten a lot of questions about, like, what kind of mascara do you use, or lip gloss, or what have you. Right. So, let me tell you this. I use CoverGirl mascara. Everyone thinks that we use such expensive things just because we're on television. Right. This thing is like $5. Okay, I've been using this for years. It doesn't clump. John knows nothing about this.
I'm a big fan of it not clumping.
And it doesn't clump.
Mascara, right?
That's like the worst thing ever, right?
I saw the clumps, the Nutty Professor movie. Is that kind of?
No, that's just a little different. A little different, right?
But it can work. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people don't use an eyelash curler. It's so important to curl your eyelashes before you put the mascara on. It was so funny because I was talking to somebody who works there. They're like, I don't use that because it looks like it's going to, like, attack my eye.
It's like a torture device.
Right.
It doesn't. Cool. It doesn't. So try it and then see if your eyes look a little bit different. One of my favorite lip glosses I cannot live without is from MAC. It's called Purr. P-R-R-R.
Yeah. She uses about 10 times an hour.
I do. Do you know why? It's because I'm always eating during the show.
Right.
So I have to reapply. Yes, and I'm willing to admit that. And then any kind of pencil that you like, you know, it's all from MAC. Mm-hmm. All right, this is a must-have. When I thought that they were discontinuing it at Victoria's Secret, I went straight to the top.
She protested.
I did. I did not, but it did almost get discontinued, and then it came back in, like, a different packaging. This is bronzing lotion. This will literally change your life, and I wore hardly any clothes today just to show you how it works. I'm not kidding, and then you can get a bronzing brush, but I use this in the winter and the summer.
But it doesn't stay on, right? It washes off.
Correct. Yeah, it's just like a lotion, and I don't really like to use tanning beds a whole lot. You know, in the summer, I like to lay out at the pool a little bit, but this only enhances, then we don't have a tan at all, like, during the winter. It's perfect. Yeah.
That's
so
awesome.
It's just a few, you know, beauty tips that I like to use. Okay, next, it's baby time. This could not have been the most perfect gift I got at a baby shower from one of my girlfriends back home. This is a car toy, and you put this on the back of their seat, and it plays. So this goes, it's like a garage door opener, and you put
it
on your visor, and all you do, like, you have access, hold on a second. You can play sleepy music to put her to sleep.
Kendo, it's sleepy time.
Yeah,
it is, yeah.
Follow the lines.
Or you can play happy music.
Cute.
And you can adjust the volume. So here's a little video I took on the way to church yesterday.
Oh, cute. Isn't that cute?
That's awesome.
So it keeps her busy and occupied.
Yes, and it glows. So obviously
so
it wasn't dark on the way to church, but the little white part glows.
Like even at night, how soothing.
So you see, she's not crying.
No, she's not crying.
It's working.
And then you can see her too then.
Yes.
Yeah.
Which is wonderful. All you have to do is just adjust your rear view mirror just a little bit, or buy those portable ones.
Yeah. Right.
So this is the perfect gift. Yeah, she never cries in the car for mommy.
Yeah.
Okay, so all these beautiful packages is something that I've been giving as a gift for a long time. They're cheese balls. Now, it may look a little awkward. But it's yummy. It's only red, you know, for the festive spirit.
And let's get the dusting of things on.
This is my grandma's cheese ball, and I have a picture of my grandma with my mom and my little cousin Ruby that I think you guys might have it, but she's been making this for years, and this is something we have to have, not even at Christmas.
This is a staple, right?
This is a staple in the Capel household.
It's a Capel staple.
Yes. So on the right is my grandma. I call her my baka. My mom on the left and my little cousin Ruby, who's been on the show before, when they came into town. So I'm going to show you how to make this.
Okay.
First, they have the gloves
already. Is that
Velveeta? Let me, can you hand me my gloves?
Yes.
And then put yours on.
We have rubber gloves on.
Because this,
take my rings off.
Is serious stuff.
I lease these.
Only because I don't have a sink nearby.
Okay.
Okay. So you throw in a whole package of Velveeta cheese. Start breaking that apart.
Alrighty.
Two packages. A Philadelphia cream cheese.
That hurt. That was heavy.
Bam.
Another
heavy
one.
Cheese.
Do we start smushing it all together?
Yes, please. Smush it all together.
Okay.
And then you're going to take two packages of sharp cheddar cheese.
Sharp.
I can't open it because my gloves are. Okay.
So this is so nice. This is a great gift.
Yes. And you know.
This is not just one cheese ball, though.
No, the recipe makes about 8 to 10 small to medium cheese balls, but if you want to make some bigger ones, obviously, maybe about 5. It's so easy to make. I've been making it for years, and every place I've worked, I've given them as gifts. Good, you guys are doing really well.
We're bonding, Tom.
Yes, we are.
Okay.
And you want 2 tablespoons. Before, so this is a first for us.
Two tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce.
Ooh.
See you.
Oh,
and this is a half because I couldn't find my full, so four.
Don't spill this anywhere.
And I gotta make it. Keep going, guys.
Oh my gosh.
Keep going.
We're squeezing.
And then a little teaspoon of some garlic powder.
I know mine too. Okay, wait, what's this?
Garlic powder.
Garlic powder.
Just a little bit, a little teaspoon. Throw that in there. And then that's all. Now work that together. You have about, how much, Tricia? About a minute?
30
about 30.
Seconds.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
Pressure's
now work
on.
It together faster.
Oh my gosh, Capel. Okay.
All right, you got it. You got
all right, I'll now I'm going to show you how to roll it. So take it.
This cheese flying. Look out.
Here, hold this. Move this.
Of course, this would get crazy.
Now, what you're going to do is you're going to roll it. Let me take these off. You're going to roll it in chili powder.
I just flung cheese all over you.
I think it's in my hair. It's in my hair.
Oh, it's in your hair? That's all right.
Take chili powder and paprika. Now, you could do the hot chili powder if you wanted, but this is what you're going to roll it in to make it look like that festive color.
Okay.
Okay? So once you roll it, here, go, roll.
I'm trying. You keep.
Good. Okay. Yes. Now this is going to be yours to take home because
I cannot wait.
Some of the cheese may be missing since you guys didn't squeeze it hard enough. Okay. And then after you're done, you will roll
it. Cheese ball.
Or wrap it in a plastic wrap.
Okay.
And then all you do is you put tissue paper around it and then tie a bow on it.
That's beautiful.
And what you could also do.
I love that.
I know, right? What you could also do is put a gift card underneath, so it has like something to stick, like a Christmas card, and then give it as a gift.
That's adorable.
So here's a display in the front, and then you can also take one to a party if you want, and Ritz has the festive crackers. Okay, it doesn't go there, but that's okay.
That's where I want it.
That's yours. And then what I do is I put a little bit of hot sauce.
Of course you do, Chrissy.
So cracker, little cheese, and some hot sauce on top.
Okay.
All right.
That's I love it. What a great gift.
Isn't that fun?
I love it. It's a great
idea. And I'll put the recipe on our website, foxaid.com. Try it. You are going to love it. It's a little spicy, but that's about it.
That's a nice cheese ball.
It's not like grandma's.
You know, right?
Just homemade.
It's okay. She's watching right now in North Carolina.
Hello.
Is this what your hands look like when you're done?
Thank you for this great recipe.
That's awesome.
How fun. Okay, so all this again on our website. Thank you, guys.
I love your favorite
things. Mm-hmm. Thank you.